Assalamu alaikum. Welcome all to Easy Human Anatomy channel. In this video, I discuss difference between somatosensory pathway. In this video, I discuss the main ascending tract, the lateral spinothalamic, anterior spinothalamic, and tract of gracilis and cunnilinus. At first, what is tract? Tract is the collections of the axons within the central nervous system. There are two types of tract. Someone is the ascending tract, another is the descending tract. Descending tract carry motor water from the brain to the effector organ, for example, skeletal muscle. The ascending tract receives sensory information, and this sensory information received by the receptor and by using several neuron, ultimately these sensory information goes to primary sensory area. There are two types of ascending tracts present in our body. One carry the conscious sensation, another carry unconscious sensation. In this video, I discuss the conscious sensation. Now, the locations of these three tracts within the spinal cord. This is the cross sections of the spinal cord. This is the A-shaped inner gray matter. This is central canal. This is the posterior horn, which is longer and narrower than the anterior horn. In front of the anterior horn, this is the location of the anterior spinothalamic tract, and this is the locations of the lateral spinothalamic tract. Just medial to the posterior horn, this is the location of tract of gracilis and tract of cunnilinus. The sensation. The lateral spinothalamic tract carry pain and temperature sensation. The anterior spinothalamic tract carry light touch and pressure sensation. The tract of gracilis and cunnilinus carry dyskinetic touch, vibration, conscious muscle and joint sensation. The receptor is related with the lateral and anterior spinothalamic are the free nerve ending. And this is related with the tract of gracilis and cunnilinus is Meissner's corpuscle, Pacinian corpuscle, Raphe ending, tendon organ, muscle spindle, etc. The sensory information is carried by the three set of neuron, first order, second order and third order. The location of the first order neuron is within the posterior root ganglia. And it is pseudo-unipolar neuron. It has one process which is divided into a peripheral process and central process. The terminal end of the peripheral process is converted into receptor. So this is the free nerve ending, then the peripheral process, then the central process. The central process is synapse with the second order neuron. So this pseudo-unipolar neuron is the first order neuron for all three tract. This is the cross sections of the spinal cord. This is the inner H-shaped gray matter. This is the posterior horn. Here the nerve cell body of neuron present, and this group of neuron is known as the substantia gelatinosa. So the central process of the pseudo-unipolar neuron present within the dorsal root ganglia is synapse with the nerve cell body present within the substantia gelatinosa. So the second order neuron is the present within the substantia gelatinosa in case lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract. And this is the lower part of the medulla oblongata. Here two nucleus are present. You know what do you mean by nucleus? Nucleus mean collections of nerve cell body. So this is nucleus gracilis, this is nucleus cunnilinus. So this central process of the this pseudo-unipolar neuron is synapse with the nucleus gracilis and nucleus cunnilinus. So for tract of gracilis and cunnilinus, second order neuron is nucleus gracilis and cunnilinus. The third order neuron is same for the all three tract, the ventral posterior lateral nucleus of the thalamus. You know what is thalamus? Thalamus is the large collection of the gray matter which present in the dorsal part of the diencephalon. So this is the telencephalon, and this is the diencephalon. So thalamus is present in the dorsal part of the diencephalon, and it's contains so many nuclei. So this group of nuclei is known as the ventral posterolateral nuclei, which receive here present the third order neuron for all three ascending tract. Now spinal lemniscus. Spinal lemniscus is a part of the lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract. And tract of gracilis and cunetus is not related with the spinal lemniscus. This is the first order neuron for tract of gracilis, and this is the second order neuron. The axon of the second order neuron is cross the side and goes to the opposite side. So this portion is known as the medial lemniscus. So medial lemniscus is the part of tract of gracilis and cunetus. The final destination is the postcentral gyrus of the cerebrum, the area number 3, 1, 2. This is the primary sensory area. Now the what happened in the lesions of this, any part of this tract. If there is a lesion in this part, so the sensation of the opposite side is failed to reach in this location. So the lesion is always contralateral. But what happened here, if the lesion is occur here, the sensory loss occur in the ipsilateral side. So these are the lesions of the lateral spinothalamic tract. Contralateral loss of pain and thermal sensation below the level of lesion, unable to sense pin prick or recognize hot and cold object. The anterior spinothalamic tract lesion is contralateral loss of light touch and pressure sensation below the level of the lesion. Discriminative touch with pressure, but unable to feel light touch of cotton placed against the skin. Here the ipsilateral loss of the muscle and joint sensation and 2-point discrimination and vibration below the level of the lesion, but sense of light touch is unaffected, movements are jerky and ataxic. So now the summary of the all three tract. This is the free nerve ending. This is the peripheral process of the pseudonuclear neuron. This is the central process. This central process is synapse with the neuron present within the substantia gelatinosa, and axon of the neuron of the substantia gelatinosa cross the site, it goes the opposite side. One group of axon is ascent in front of the ventral horn of the spinal cord, and another group of axon is ascent just lateral to the ventral horn of the spinal cord, and both this axon is formed the spinal lemniscus, and both axons of the lateral and anterior spinothalamic tract is synapse with the nerve cell body present in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of the thalamus. And then the axons of the ventral posterolateral nucleus is ultimately reach the primary sensory area. This is the first order neuron. And this is the central process. Is central process is synapse with the nucleus gracilis and cunetus, then it's cross the opposite side, and this portion is known as the medial lemniscus, and they synapse with the ventral posterolateral nucleus of the thalamus, and it ultimately leads the primary sensory area, area number 3, 1, 2. So this is all about the ascending tract. If you like this video, please press the like button and please subscribe my channel.